Well, hello, all my friends. Welcome back to the channel. Or if you are joining us for the first time, hi, my name is T and this is my YouTube channel, Crumpets Tea and Sewing. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you a pattern haul as well as a fabric haul. In the pattern haul, I'm going to be sharing with you some of the Vogue patterns that I picked up from the latest collection. I'm also going to be sharing with you some of the Simplicity patterns that I picked up as well. And then for my fabric haul, I have fabrics from fabric.com, mood fabrics, and I also picked up a piece or two from Walmart as well. So with all that said, we're gonna go ahead and get to the video and let's look at this haul. All right, everyone, we're gonna go ahead and get started with the pattern haul first. And I wanna start first with the Vogue patterns. And I wanna start with the Vogue V1850, which is a wrap skirt pattern that just came out in Vogue's latest collection. This pattern comes in sizes 8 to 16 and 16 to 24. So you have two different envelopes and two different size groups here. The pattern is basically a simple wrap skirt. It's an asymmetrical wrap skirt and you have two different views here. So there are two different length variations. So as you can see here, this model here is wearing one that is basically a midi skirt and this one is more or less a knee length skirt. So it's really cute and I think it's really simple and easy to make. It has a few different panels here that you're going to be sewing together. And as you can see, Vogue classifies this as an easy pattern. So this is going to be for your beginners and your advanced beginners. And then also the fabric suggestions are synthetic leather, rayon crepe, ponte knits, and linen blends. But the structure of this, definitely I would say you can get away with a cotton type fabric. So I really like this skirt and I'm not quite for certain what I would make with it yet, like what kind of fabric I would use with it, but I thought that it was really cute and simple and definitely something easy that you can pull out and sew up real quick. So I think this would be a really great pattern. Next, I picked up the Vogue V1841, which is a dress that has bishop sleeves and a keyhole opening. You are going to be putting a zipper down the center back. You also have a slit in the back of the dress as well. And you have these cuffs that you're going to be putting on the garment as well. This pattern has two different size groups. So you're sewing, so you can choose the 8 to 16 and the 16 to 24. The fabric suggestions here are two-way stretch knit fabrics with at least 50% stretch on the cross grain. And it's saying that you need fabrics such as sequin mesh, rayon spandex, stretch velvet, those types of fabrics. And I am really looking forward to making like a really simple Christmas dress with this. I think that you can really dress this up really great, or you can just make something that is semi-casual. And that's why I picked this up, because it could be really elegant and dressy or a semi-casual look. So I think this is also a really great pattern. I also picked up the Vogue V1849, which is a pattern that has two different versions of a skirt. You can get this pattern in sizes 8 to 16 or 16 to 24. As I stated before, you have two different variations of a skirt. This one here features a skirt that has buttons down the center front and an asymmetrical hem. And you also have these side pockets, these little slanted side pockets that you're going to be placing on the garment as well. The garment features a waistband and you're also going to be sewing darts in the back of the skirt. For view A, it's basically the same thing as view B, with the exception of you're not going to be placing buttons on the center front of the garment. And I really like this style. I had an Ann Taylor skirt that was very similar to this a few years ago. And so when I saw this pattern, it immediately reminded me of that skirt. And I really do miss that skirt. And the fabrics are synthetic leather, medium weight crepe, rayon challis, crepe back satin, and similar fabrics. So yeah, I really like this. And I am excited to actually recreate that Ann Taylor skirt. I got this Simplicity S8742. This is a Simplicity coat that I believe came out in, if not the previous fall collection, the year before that. I cannot remember, but this is a loose fitting coat. You have three different variations here, or is it four different variations that you have of a coat, and it comes in extra small to extra large. And I think this is really fun. And I'm going to be doing a collaboration with someone on this. I'm really excited to actually work with this pattern. It has 7 pieces, and you are using fabrics such as boiled wool, double knit, fleece, ponte, and those types of fabrics. So you have different length variations as well. I also picked up this Cynthia Rowley pattern, which is the Simplicity S9098. You have 2 different variations of a top and a blouse. And I also like the fact that it has like this tie belt with it. You have these really nice big statement sleeves. You have gathering on the shoulder there. It's really cute. And then also you can make it in a top or a blouse. So I really like it. And I think I'm going to go ahead and give it a try. From Simplicity's latest collection, I picked up the Mimi G Simplicity S9450. And at first, I was a little bit indifferent about the skirt, but I think that I'm going to go ahead and give it a try and see how it sews up. I really like the easiness of it. I think this is probably the easiest pattern that I've actually seen of Mimi G's. And so I definitely want to go ahead and give this a try. It's just a wrap skirt. It has, I think, what is this? 1, 2, 3 different panels. And then you have ties that you're going to be putting on your wrap skirt to actually tie it in the front. So I really like it. And I think that it's going to be very versatile as well. The fabric suggestions are size for knit fabrics such as fleece, French terry, lightweight ponte, lightweight scuba, and sweatshirt fleece. And I think that the scuba knit fabric would be perfect for this wrap skirt. So I think I'm going to go ahead and give this a try and see what it sews up like. Lastly, I purchased the Simplicity S9453. These little classic dresses are always fun to have in your stash. I like the fact that View A has a tulip sleeve, and then you have this gathering on the sleeve head as well that you can make for Views B and C. You have different length variations as well. And this pattern is calling for brocade, cottons, linens, rayons, satins, silks, velvet, you know, those types of fabric. And I think it's very versatile because you can use different types of fabrics. And so I really like this, and I thought it was really fun. Like I said, it's not anything new, but it does look like it's a fun pattern that you can use to sew with. So those are all the patterns that I picked up for my pattern haul. I'm hoping to get, you know, some of these done before the year is out, but I don't know. I might. This one here and this one here, these two are 2 skirts that I definitely want to get into my wardrobe really quickly. So who knows? I'll probably get it done by the end of the year. If not the beginning of the year, I'm definitely going to try to focus my attention on making more skirts anyway. And I think these two are going to be on the top of the list. Okay, so with all that said, let's go ahead and turn our attention to fabrics. Okay, the first piece I picked up is this piece here. This was a $4 piece that I purchased from Walmart. It was 2 yards for $4. You know, Walmart and some locations, they have these bundles. And so I picked this up, and I had already shown this on the channel, but just in case you guys haven't seen it, I decided to go ahead and put it in this particular haul as well because I just recently purchased this. It's really beautiful. It's a rayon challis fabric. It has quite a bit of drape to it. It's a black fabric, and on the foreground you have these really nice pinkish red flowers, and then you also have little blue flowers as well. And like I said, it's a really cool fabric, so I'm really looking forward to doing something with this. Since it was so inexpensive, I think that I would actually use this for like mock-up purposes for like one of the wrap skirts that I am planning on making here pretty soon. I also picked up this sweater knit here from Walmart as well. Now, I got 3 yards of this for $8, and it's a really thin sweater knit. And this is one of those Hachi fabrics, and it's really lightweight, and I think it would make a really nice cardigan because it's so light, and it would be perfect for layering with a t-shirt or something like that. It's really nice, and it's navy blue, and you have these really nice big floral red flowers on the face of the fabric, and then there's also some orange flowers on here as well. So I really like this print, and the fabric feels amazing. It's very soft, and yeah, very amazing. From Mood Fabrics, I picked up this piece here. Now, this is supposed to be a sweater fabric, a jersey sweater fabric. This is not a jersey sweater fabric at all. This feels more like a rayon fabric. I was very disappointed when I purchased this and when I received this in the mail. And this was labeled as a sweater knit. But yeah, I can tell you it is not. Like, it looks and appears as if it's a sweater knit. It has like these really fine lines that resemble really thin rib knits going throughout the fabric, but it's not. It's very silky, and as you can see, it's translucent, and you can see through it somewhat. So yeah, this is a very thin fabric. I was very disappointed. I really like the print, these big purple flowers, and I like that it's on a navy blue background, but it's definitely not what I was expecting in terms of the fiber and the content of the fabric. It's not a bad fabric, it's just not what I was expecting. From Mood Fabric, I picked up this nice sweater knit jersey fabric. Now, this is definitely a sweater knit. It is a little bit on the thin side, but I was expecting that, especially for the price. I think this particular fabric was $6.99 a yard. I really like this cheetah print here, and you have like this gradient on the fabric, so it starts like a lavender color here, and then it slightly gets lighter and lighter as it moves throughout the fabric on this side. So I really like it. Let's see if I can show you. So yeah, it's a really nice fabric. It is, like I said, a lightweight fabric, and so this would be more for fall, not for winter, unless you're going to layer it with something. But it is a gorgeous fabric, and I thought that it was quite beautiful in terms of the color and how it looks. I really like this one, and I'm thinking about making the McCall's M8247 with this. I had already been doing mock-ups of that, and so I was thinking about doing that with this piece here. Next, I picked up this rayon jersey from Mood Fabrics as well. This is definitely something that you would want to use for late spring and early summer. It's very lightweight, even maybe late summer. It's very lightweight, very thin. I'm surprised that it's not as sheer as I expect it to be, considering it's so thin. The face of the fabric have these floral designs. You have purple, like this really lavender shade, this really nice lavender shade of purple. You have some darker tones here of purple, and then also some gray shades as well. I really like the fabric. And then on the background, you have, it's on a gray background. So I purchased this piece here from fabric.com. This is such a beautiful fabric. It is a black fabric that have all these beautiful floral details on the face of the fabric. There's so many colors here that I don't even know where to start. But you know, you can see the fabric here, and you can see all these different colors. They're just so amazing, and I really like this piece. It's just so bright and so cheerful. And I think this would be a beautiful dress, especially something for fall or spring. Just such a beautiful dress, even for summer. I think this you can actually wear pretty much every season, maybe even winter. It's just such a beautiful, beautiful, bright piece. Here's another Rayon Challis piece from fabric.com. It is a navy blue fabric that has polka dots on it, and the polka dots are red. I was thinking Christmas and in my mind when I picked this up. I just think that this would be so cute for Christmas, and I know it's on a navy blue background, but the red dots just stand out so much, and I think that this would be a beautiful dress for Christmas. Don't know if I'm going to be able to get a dress done with this fabric by Christmas because I have so many plans, but I think this is a beautiful, beautiful piece here. I'm definitely happy with this purchase. Here's a chunky rib sweater knit fabric. Actually, I think this is a cable knit fabric, and this was also purchased off of fabric.com. It's a really nice chunky fabric, sweater fabric. I was expecting this to be, let's see, a little bit more tightly woven than what it is. This is very loose. It's a loose weave here, and I just did not expect it to be like that. But with that said, I still really do like the fabric. It feels really nice, and I think this would be really nice as a dress or a really nice chunky cardigan or something like that. And that's one of the reasons why I got this piece, because I don't have these types of sweater knits in my stash, and so I wanted to also pick up a couple of sweater knits. So speaking of more sweater knits, I have one more piece that I want to share with you, and that is a sweater knit as well. This mustard color sweater knit is just so beautiful. I really like this. It's not coming up true to color on here. It's actually a little bit darker, but it is a really nice weight. It's not too heavy, which I really like, and it's not too light. So it's a medium weight, and it's really nice, and I'm looking forward to making a cardigan with this. So that's basically everything that I actually picked up, and I'm excited to be able to get to work on all these things. All right, everyone, so that does it for today's video. Thank you so much for hanging out today. If this is your first time tuning into the channel and you also like the content here, please make sure that you subscribe if you haven't done so already. Don't forget to hit the notification bell also so that you can receive notifications of all my videos when I upload them. All right, everyone, I hope you all have a blessed day and stay creative. Bye.